Morning.
Good morning.
Welcome to our fourth Sunday of Advent. We are glad that you are here. We want to welcome Suzanne Jeter, who's our guest organist today. Came in from Charleston and has been here a couple of other times in the past. We just want to welcome you back. Thank you. A few announcements today. The Christmas Joy offering will be received a little bit later. And alternative gift giving is still an option maybe for some of you. The recommendation is to use the local food bank. And we will have Christmas Eve service. It'll be at 6 o'clock this Thursday. So again, come, we invite you, and bring friends. Also have a guest with us today, Beth Terrell. She probably should petition to be an assistant or associate pastor, or minister, not minister. Member here, because she's been frequenting here from Hollywood. She's a member of James Island Press, but I think it's 8 minutes more to get here than it is to go to James Island, so we're glad that you're with us again, Beth. This campus was busy this past week with First Steps going on. I think almost 400 gifts were prepared, and they adapted to a system because of COVID, so it was Monday or Tuesday and Wednesday, basically the parking lot used as a drive-through. So a lot of people served, and thanks to all those who are part of this congregation who are engaged in that ministry. And certainly it was an awesome time to see all the people coming through and picking up their gifts. We have received some messages from Sheldon and Joan that just want to share appreciation for prayers, for food, for everything else. Not over the last couple of weeks, but over the last 14 months, which is how long he's been in and out of the hospital. So continue, however, to pray for them. Had a long conversation with Gary Hutchinson last night. Again, they continue to grieve, but also want to share appreciation to the congregation for all the gestures of hospitality and just comfort that they've received. The committal service was this past Wednesday for their son, Mark, up here in Live Oak. Got a call from Bucky. His mother, of course, has been with him for a few weeks, and she's still got a lot of health issues going on. He also has an upper respiratory problem going on, so prayers for that family as well. And then Larry had a rough evening last night. Joyce is with us today. Virtual hugs or real hugs to Joyce and to Larry, and our prayers continue to be with them. One of the things that you'll see in the bulletin is this is an opportunity to do a lot of singing today. I think there's 10 hymns. We can become Episcopalian-like and we can stand up and sit down at each one, or we're going to be Presbyterian today, and let's stand at the first one and the last one and sit down for all of the rest. I see a lot of nods, so I think those are nods of appreciation. Marshals are not here today because they are sick. So we have Michael and Susan Hicklin, who will be coming in a little bit later for the Advent wreath. A lot of stuff happening in our lives. A lot of adaptations because of COVID, but we are here to worship God. We are here simply to pause in the busyness of this season to say thank you, Lord, for the gift of peace and love and joy and hope. As we listen to this morning's prelude, let's prepare our hearts for worship.
Thank you.
join me in this morning's call to worship. An angel spoke to Mary, "Do not be afraid.
The child she carries will be God's son, and the world will never be the same."
An angel spoke to Mary, "Do not be afraid.
God was with her, and God is with us. Draw us into worship and praise."
Friends, let us worship God. Watch and wait for Christ's coming. We light candles of hope, peace, joy, and love, remembering the promises of God for us.
We light this candle in hope. We light this candle in peace. We light this candle in joy. And we light this candle in love. Hear the word from the Psalms. We will sing of God's steadfast love forever. We will proclaim the faithfulness of the Lord to all generations. Hear the word from the Gospel. With Mary we pray, "Let it be with us according to your word, for nothing will be impossible with God."
Pray together. God of hope, God of peace, God of joy and of love, teach us how to love one another. Teach us to love this world and all people as reflections of your light in this world. And God of hope, peace, joy, and love, enter into our darkness. Come.
This
This morning we will go through 8 different lessons as we hear the story. First will be prophecy, the coming of the Messiah, and then through the story of Jesus born. Listen to the word of God from our first lesson from Isaiah 9, verses 2 through 7. The people who walked in darkness have seen a great light. Those who lived in the land of deep darkness, on them light has shined. You have multiplied the nation, you have increased its joy, and they rejoice before you, as with joy at the harvest, as people exult when dividing the plunder. For the yoke of their burden and the bar across their shoulders, the rod of their oppressor, you have broken as the day of Midian. For all the boots of the trampling warriors and the garments rolled in blood shall be burned as fuel for the fire. For a child has been born for us, a son given to us. Authority rests upon his shoulders, and he is named Wonderful Counselor, Mighty God, Everlasting Father, Prince of Peace. His authority shall grow continually, and there will be endless peace for the throne of David and for his kingdom. And he will establish and uphold it with justice and with righteousness, from this time onward and forevermore. The zeal of the Lord of hosts will do this. Friends, this is the word of God for the people of God. Thanks be to God. Lift it up, do not fear, saith to the cities of Judah, Here is your God.
Thank you.
from Luke 2, verses 1 through 7. In those days, a decree went out from Emperor Augustus that all the world should be registered. This was the first registration and was taken while Quirinius was governor of Syria. So all went to their own towns to be registered. Joseph also went from the town of Nazareth in Galilee to Judea, the city of David called Bethlehem, because he was descended from the house and the family of David. He went to be registered with Mary, to whom he was engaged and who was expecting a child. And while they were there, the time came for her to deliver her child. And she gave birth to her firstborn son and wrapped him in bands of cloth and laid him in a manger because there was no place for them in the inn. The angel said to them, "Do not be afraid, for see, I bring you good news of great joy for all the people. To you is born this day in the city of David a Savior, who is the Messiah, the Lord. And this will be a sign for you. You will find the child wrapped in bands of cloth and lying in a manger."
Thank you.
from Matthew 2, verses 1 through 12. In the time of King Herod, after Jesus was born in Bethlehem of Judea, wise men from the east came to Jerusalem, asking, "Where is the child who has been born King of the Jews? For we observed his star at the rising, and we have come to pay him homage." When King Herod heard that about this news, he was frightened, and all of Jerusalem with him. And he called together the chief priests and the scribes of the people, and he inquired where this Messiah was to be born. And they told him, "In Bethlehem of Judea, for so it has been written by the prophet, 'And you, Bethlehem, in the land of Judah, are by no means least among the rulers of Judah. For from you shall come a ruler who is to shepherd my people Israel.'" Then Herod secretly called for the wise men, and he learned from them the exact time when the star had appeared. And he sent to them to Bethlehem and said, "Go and search diligently for this child. And when you have found him, bring me word so that I may also go and pay him homage." When they had heard the king, they set out. And there, ahead of them, went the star that they had seen in its rising, until it stopped over the place where the child was. When they saw that the star had stopped, they were overwhelmed with joy. On entering the house, they saw the child with Mary, his mother. And they knelt down, and they paid him homage. And they opened their treasure chests, and they offered him gifts of gold and frankincense and myrrh. And having been warned in a dream not to return to Herod, they left for their own country by another road.
Suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, dead, and buried.
to judge the quick and the dead. I believe in the Holy Ghost, the Holy Catholic Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
Please be seated. We know over the last 10 weeks that we have come back for in-person worship, that the offering is not taken during the service, it's actually received as we exit the sanctuary. But we use this time simply to pause and to reflect as we hear a hymn being played. Sunday in Advent, as we ponder the gift of God becoming flesh, that we may be restored, that we may be given new life in Christ, it gives us joy. Jesus, the Christ child, your gift to us. Help us, Lord, to live according to your commandments, to love you with our whole being, and also to love others as ourselves. Help us to hear those throughout the world that are crying out in pain and loneliness or poverty. Give us ears to hear their hopes and fears so that together we may restore your world and the foundation of justice that you intended for us in Christ. Family, we lift to you those in this church family, and our individual families, our community, and throughout the world who struggle with this Christmas season, Not that it's about Christmas, it's just about loneliness for many. We pray for those dealing with loss, income, loss of health, loss of loved ones, loss of security. We pray for the frontline healthcare providers who face and deal with COVID-19 every day. We pray for our leaders and those in positions of authority and throughout the world that are trying to govern in these challenging times. We pray for congregations everywhere who are trying to find adaptive ways to worship and to minister. And we thank you, Lord, for all that you've given us, including a new and a promising vaccine. We thank you for the blessing of gathering in our homes or churches to worship and to praise you. We thank you, Lord, for the joy that is ours because of the promise of your birth that we celebrate in just a few days. And Lord, we thank you for the promise that no matter how tough life gets, you are always with us. Lord, we close this time with the family prayer that you gave us. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our debts, as we forgive our debtors. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory forever. Amen. The seventh lesson comes from John 1, verses 1 through 5 and 10 through 14. In the beginning was the Word, and the Word was with God, and the Word was God. He was in the beginning with God, and all things came into being through him. And without him, not one thing came into being. What has come into being in him was life, and the life was the light of all people. The light shines in the darkness, and the darkness did not overcome it. He was in the world, and the world came into being through him, yet the world did not know. He came to what was his own, and his own people did not accept him. But to all who received him, who believed in his name, he gave power to become children of God, who were born not of blood, or of the will of the flesh, or of the will of man, but of God. And the Word became flesh and lived among us, and we have seen his glory, the glory as of a Father's only Son, full of grace and truth.
Thank you.
Final lesson comes from Luke 2, verses 13 and 14. And suddenly there was with the angel a multitude of the heavenly host, praising God and saying, "Glory to God in the highest heaven, and on earth peace among those he favors." Friends, this is the word of the Lord. Thanks be to God. Simple question, I thought, what are we having for dinner? And she said we were having tomato soup. Tomato soup on a Thursday is a clue for me to respond, "Let's go out to eat instead." Well, on Thursdays we go to this place on James Island. It's known for the Thursday 50% off hamburger platters. So you get a big old burger of your choice, you get french fries, and it's $5. Of course, that's where we went. So we're sitting there, my back's to the door, and all of a sudden somebody pushes me on the back, and I turn, and it's a guy by the name of Mark Hunt. Mark Hunt is an old friend, used to be a pastor of Rockville Presbyterian in Wabamala. But over the last couple of years, he's been in La Paz, Bolivia. So he left Guabala at 14 feet above sea level to La Paz, which is right at 12,000 above sea level. We were wondering why he was there and asked him, and he said, well, because of the political situation in Bolivia, way back in August, he sent his family ahead of him to stay with family here in the States. And they were going to spend some time on James Island. And he had only just returned to the States himself the night before, so he said he was anxiously waiting for 4 months to be able to be reunited with his family. And what a reunited time it was of celebration. First scripture we read tonight was from Isaiah. And the prophet was sharing 800 years before the birth of the Christ. Be patient and wait, because the Messiah is coming. We have to wait 4 more days or so for Christmas Eve and then Christmas, and we celebrate the birth of Christ. But more important, Jesus is already with us. We know that Jesus is in this place. He is in our beings. He is in our hearts. And he extends to us the challenge to bring his life, his joy, his peace, his light into the world. As we leave this place of worship, let us be the light. The light of Christ is already here, already with us. As we enter into this week, may the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, the fellowship and the community, the Holy Spirit be with each of you now and forever. Amen.